Welcome to this lecture on airline operations. My name is Bruno Santos, and I'm an assistant professor at the Air Transport and Operations Group at our faculty. I would like to start this lecture by asking two questions. The first one is, why do we need to fly? Well, the capability of flying gives us access to several places and activities which could hardly be reached if there wouldn't be airlines. Think, for instance, on small islands or remote territories. Additionally, even though we have recently learned how to work remotely and travel less, some activities require our presence, and there is always the fun of visiting new places. Airlines are also crucial for trade, particularly to transport perishable cargo items that cannot spend a few days inside a boat. The second question is, are airlines really non-sustainable? The answer to this is not necessary, and yes. So, what do I mean with these ambiguous answers? Well, if we look at the three pillars of sustainability, social, economic, and environmental, airlines play a vital role in our society, as I just mentioned. They also have an essential role in our economies. So, airlines are sustainable according to these two pillars. However, they are typically the less environmentally friendly transport option. So in this lecture, I'll focus on this last pillar. In particular, we will discuss some of the solutions that airlines can follow to reduce their operations footprint. To do this, I'll refer to the airline planning framework. This framework summarizes the different decision processes within the airlines, from the strategic level, 1 to 5 years before operations, to the decision at the time of flying. Let's start with the strategic decisions. 2 to 5 years before flying, the airlines have to make their decisions regarding which aircraft they will have in their fleet. Fleet planning, particularly fleet renewal, is a significant challenge for airlines to become more sustainable in the future. The new, more eco-friendly aircraft and propulsion technologies that we have discussed in this course will only be a better alternative if and when adopted by airlines. But the fleet renewal process is a financially demanding problem, representing a long-term commitment for airlines. It takes many years for airlines to renew their fleets. Not all airlines have the purchasing power to do so. So the incentive to speed up this renewing effort has eventually to come from states, either by providing financial advantages for airlines to buy greener aircraft, or via carbon taxes or penalties, as the CORSIA scheme promoted by the United Nations. This is a carbon reduction scheme to lower CO2 emissions for international flights. The problem with this scheme is that it is still voluntary and does not present a meaningful monetary incentive for a fleet renewing yet. But we, passengers, we can also play a role in this fleet renewing urgency. We can decide to fly airlines with newer and more eco-friendly technologies. Let's now talk about airlines network. The network of an airline can be influenced by differential carbon taxes or innovative operational solutions. For instance, research shows that intermediate stop operations, in which long-haul flights are split into two or more short segments, can reduce fuel burn by 5 to 10%. The savings come from carrying less fuel when the aircraft takes off, or using smaller aircraft with lower ranges. More interestingly, is the fact that these type of operations can represent a promising solution to overcome the range limitation of, for instance, hybrid or turbo-electric aircraft. Another network option is to stop flying short-haul flights and replace them, for instance, with rail alternatives in an integrated intermodal network. This was done, for example, by Austrian Airlines, which in 2020 replaced its flights between Vienna and the city of Graz with a train option. Or recently, by the French government that decided to ban all internal flights journeys shorter than 2.5 hours. Solutions like these are only possible when a rail option is present and represents a practical alternative to flying. When you move in time, about 1 year before operations, the airline schedule has to be defined. This is the moment that the timetable is defined and the resources are allocated to each flight in the timetable. According to a study from the start of the century, airlines could potentially reduce by 10% their required fleet if they would optimize their schedule from a clean slate. The goal will have to be to increase the flight's load factors by allocating aircraft of smaller size and by eventually reducing the flight's frequencies. It will be, however, hard for airlines to decide their schedule from scratch, and passengers will have to accept less frequent flights between their destinations. Nevertheless, it is not too hard to believe that in the era of machine learning, we can expect similar operational impacts to the ones estimated in the study from 2002. Schedules can now be optimized for efficient and resilient operations by being capable of predicting and considering future irregular operations. Once a timetable for the next year is defined, and it is known which aircraft will be allocated to each flight, the airline starts the revenue management process. The first step is pricing, which is the process of defining ticket fare classes. An airline, even a low-cost carrier, can have more than 10 different classes for the same seat. The revenue management part manages which fare class is available at any time to maximize the revenue generated with the bookings. So how can an airline reduce its footprint during this process? I give you two examples here. The first one is by offering a carbon offset program. When you purchase your tickets at many airlines, you can already voluntarily pay the costs associated with your trip carbon footprint. On the other hand, other airlines, like EasyJet, choose to pay the offsetting costs without asking for the direct contribution from passengers. In both modalities, we need to remember that the carbon offset option is not a solution to the problem, but the mitigation action. The second solution at revenue management is to sell virtual products to replace flights. Some airlines and travel agencies are becoming aware of the need to reduce the number of flights to achieve our climate targets. So they are selling virtual experiences, like virtual conferences or touristic tours, using 360-degree views on your computer, or offering an immersive experience by borrowing virtual reality headsets. Another tactical decision is the scheduling of the aircraft maintenance. This is a necessary process to keep the aircraft airworthy and ready to operate at all time. But it generates waste. Standard steps for more environmental friendly maintenance operations are to adopt waste management procedures and to use eco-friendly chemicals when performing tasks. But the current challenge in maintenance is to adopt smarter maintenance policies and, in particular, condition-based maintenance policies. The idea is to use aircraft sensors and other inspection techniques to constantly monitor the health conditions of aircraft components, including engine systems and structures. With such policy, the components can be used until their end of life, staying in service longer and consequently reducing waste. In addition, if reliable health monitoring solutions are developed, future generation aircraft can be designed in a less conservative way, reducing the aircraft weight and consequently the energy used to perform a flight. Let's move now to the operational decisions. These are performed in the last hours before the flight and during the flight. Here, airlines may decide to operate routes that minimize flying through climate-sensitive areas when defining their flight plans. Studies suggest that when following climate-optimized flight plans, the total climate impact can be reduced by 40% with only small extra fuel costs. Still, these flight plans have to be computed several times in a day because they depend on local weather properties, and in practice, it is not easy to estimate these climate-sensitive areas accurately. The final solution I present today is the effort already taken by several airlines to reduce the footprint of their in-flight services. This includes, for instance, the effort to have zero-waste flights, that is, to compost, recycle or reuse all paper, plastic and food items used and served on board. In similar efforts, many airlines are also eliminating in-flight sales or choosing smarter ways of selling free-duty products. This is to avoid carrying all the perfumes or other items on the flights, which represent an extra weight to be carried. These are just some solutions that airlines can follow to reduce their carbon footprint and become more sustainable. There are, of course, several other solutions possible. So I invite you to share other sustainable initiatives and ideas you may be aware of in the forum. I'll see you there. Thank you.